My daughter, she's probably going to kill me for this Lightroom tutorial because she had this gigantic, dry, flaky skin right in the middle of her forehead on the day of this photo shoot. But that's okay, because we have Lightroom, which will allow us not only to smooth the skin, but remove blemishes directly in Lightroom. And hopefully she'll forgive me once I'm done teaching you how to soften, smooth, and retouch skin in Lightroom. Hello, my name is Chris Parker, and I'm here to help you elevate your photographic skills. And retouching and smoothing the skin is super duper easy once you know how to use the retouching tools in Lightroom. But there's one problem. The editing techniques I'm going to share with you today are available only in Lightroom Classic. So if your interface looks like this, you're all set. However, if your interface looks like this, then you're not using Lightroom Classic, but instead Lightroom. Confusing, I know. So if you don't use Lightroom Classic and wish to learn how to smooth and retouch skin in your version of Lightroom, let me know in the comments below. Now, when it comes to smoothing and retouching skin, there are four editing tools you can use to fix the skin. The first one is adjusting the texture. So when you adjust the texture slider to the left, that's going to begin affecting the medium-sized detail of the skin, and it reduces the contrast, which gives the impression that you're smoothing the skin. But the problem with doing it in the basic panel in Lightroom Classic is it's a global editing tool. In other words, it's affecting the entire image. So not just her face, but her hair and the leaves and the background and everything else becomes smoother. And that's not how I recommend retouching your portraits, especially the skin. Instead, you want to target just the skin and only the skin. This means you also need to avoid the lips and the eyes and the eyebrows. This way they stay sharp. Otherwise, your images will look fake if every part of the face is smooth. And targeting just the skin is really easy with the AI tools that we have in Lightroom Classic. Now, to start the process of selecting your skin, you're going to click on the masking icon right here, and then Lightroom will automagically find the person or persons in your image. Now, check this out. If you click on the person you want to edit, Lightroom will find the face skin, the eyebrows, lips, and hair. Oh my, how cool is that? I love it. Now, at this point, you don't have a mask created yet. What you have to do is first select the options you want to create a mask of, and then you want to click on the Create Mask button here. Now, before I do that, we have one problem. When I hover over the hair option, you can see the mask overlay is including the leaf that she is holding. So what Lightroom selects is not always going to be perfect, and you may need to add or remove from the mask accordingly. So I'm going to go ahead and select the face skin and create the mask. And now let me show you how to refine it. Now, real quick, I need to point out something you probably already recognized, and that is this image is out of focus. So I did have the focus point on her eye, at least I thought I did. But it looks like it focused more on her hand versus the eye. But if you take a look at my final edit here, you can see that the eye is now in focus. So how did I do that? Well, I'll explain how I did that later on in this tutorial. Now, to refine the mask, you'll either add to it or subtract from it with these buttons right here. So I'm going to click on subtract, and then you can choose from any one of these options here. I'm going to go ahead and select the brush, and then I can go ahead and paint over the areas where the mask needs to be removed. Now, part of the leaf has been included in the mask as well. So let me show you a quick editing tip on making the process of refining your masks easier. And that is done by turning on Auto Mask. So Auto Mask will make refining your mask easier and more precise with it turned on versus off. And here's how it works. So once you click and begin applying the brush, in this case, inside of the leaf, Lightroom will take note of the colors, the texture, and the contrast. And if it comes across an area that is different, like the skin, it will not affect that area. Now, here's one more quick tip. If you make a mistake by removing too much of the mask, you can invert your brush to add it back by holding down your Alt or Option key, depending on if you're on a Mac or a PC. and then you can brush back that mask as needed. All right, now that the skin is properly selected, you can adjust the texture slider according to your personal preference. Now for me, typically I'll set this to around minus 25 to minus 50, depending on the image. Okay, so now that the skin is smoother, we still have some work to do, and that is to remove the blemishes since texture isn't designed to remove them completely. So the retouching tools can be found by clicking on this Band-Aid icon right here, or using the keyboard shortcut, which is the letter Q. So we have three retouching tools, which are the clone, heal, and content aware, and you may need to use one, two, or possibly all three to remove skin blemishes. It all depends on where that edit is being applied, and I'll show you how to use each one in just a second. First, let's go over the basics of how the tools work and the attributes so you know how to work with them. Now, to remove a blemish, you're first going to pick the retouching tool of choice, and then you're going to click on a blemish and it will magically disappear, but not always. Sometimes you'll get unexpected results. For example, if I click on this large piece of dry skin, the final result is horrible. Am I right? So why is this happening? Well, let's reveal what the retouching tool does when you apply it by pressing the letter H. Okay, we now have some circles that are part of the retouching of your skin blemishes. And as you add more and more edits, you'll have tons of these circles everywhere, and it can make the job of retouching a little bit harder. So if you want to hide them, just press the letter H again to hide them. All right, so these circles have two primary purposes. One is the target and the other is the source. So the target is the pimple or the dry skin. And when you click on it, Lightroom is responsible for finding pixels within the image to replace your target. So the second circle is the source. Sometimes Lightroom does a good job of finding the right pixels, and sometimes, like me, at least according to my wife, it's wrong. But we can assist Lightroom by changing the source and moving it to a better part of the image. And to move it, we're just going to click on the inside of the circle, and then you can move it to a new location. You can also resize the circles by clicking on the outer edge and dragging in or out if you want to make them larger. But what I like to do is increase or decrease the size of the brush before I apply it. And usually I keep the brush a little bit larger than the pimple. So you can either do that from the slider here or with the scroll button on your mouse, if you have one, of course. And then the other thing is I recommend keeping the feather and opacity at 100, and the feather provides a very soft edged brush that works better for retouching skin. Okay, let's say you want to delete one or more of these edits. If you hit your delete or backspace key, it will remove the one that is selected. To get it back, use your keyboard shortcut, which is Command or Control plus the letter Z. And to select another edit, just click on it, and then you can either reposition the target or the source or delete it. But let's say you want to get rid of all of them because you want to start over. To do that, hold down your Alt or Option key and you'll get the scissors tool. Now, click and drag around all of them or just the ones that need to be removed, release, and boom, they're all gone. Now, the other thing you should know is you're not limited to just clicking. So let's say you want to remove a stray hair. You can set the target for that hair by clicking and painting over it, and then the source takes the shape of the target. So each of these retouching tools is going to affect your skin blemishes differently. And to see this in action, let's go ahead and start with the clone tool. So the clone tool is going to copy pixels from the source and apply them to your target area, in this instance, creating a new eye, okay? So my daughter's probably not going to like this, so I'm gonna go ahead and get rid of that. Now, when it comes to retouching skin, the clone tool isn't the one that I use since the other two do a better job. So let's go ahead and check out the heal tool next. So the heal tool is taking information from the source and applying it to the target, but instead of copying the pixels exactly, It looks at the colors, the contrast, and the textures of the source, and then it blends it in with the target, which produces better results compared to the clone tool. Now, the only problem is it can be very time consuming to click and then having to reposition the source, and sometimes every single time. So you may want to consider the content aware tool since it's smarter, but it does have some limitations as well. So let's go ahead and check that one out next. Okay, so the content aware tool works slightly different than the other two, and you're going to notice that it doesn't provide a source. So instead of searching your image for pixels to use, it references the surrounding pixels of your target and will automagically blend them in to remove the skin blemish. How awesome is that? However, although I use this one more than the other two, it's not perfect either. So let's try removing this large flaky skin, and it's not really giving us good results. It's kind of dark and blotchy. So in this case, we might be better off with the hue brush. So let's go ahead and try that instead. Okay, much better results. Now, if needed, sometimes I'll add another brush stroke or two to help it blend in better. Okay, let's not forget how to fix out of focus images, which you can learn how to do when you watch this video next.